Montag, lieben Klaus und Globen.
Checked in on you in quite some time. So we're going to do a Celtic cross. For mutable fire. So Sagittarius, I've already shuffled these cards for you. That is our issue. Okay? Nice. All right, we'll count that as the issue. All right. Thinking we'll pick three piles. One, two, three. This one is calling out. All right. Bottom of the deck. Sagittarius, this is the Wheel of Fortune, which is one of your major arcana cards, actually, so that's fantastic. We'll talk about that later on, all right? I'm just going to leave that sitting at the bottom of the deck, and I'm going to lay out the rest of your Celtic cross. Alright, so we'll leave the Wheel of Fortune there, sitting upright, looking at us. Maybe we'll put a little flower on him. So, let's start with the issue and the challenge. Now, I already had a peek at the issue because it was the one that jumped out. It's great, and it's also fire energy. So we have the Ace of Wands, okay? I want you to look at how fertile that rod looks. I want you to look at how the hand is gripping the rod and notice that there are eight leaves that are falling off the wand. So aces normally, the white hand normally means blank slate, you know, anything can happen. So this could be the beginning of a very passionate project for you, the beginning of a passionate relationship. I'm feeling that there's some communication coming in because we do know that for some reason these eight leaves lead us directly to the only minor arcana card in the deck that does not have either a person or a human body part in it, which is the Eight of Wands, which is the card of communication. Little break in the tape, Sachi. Okay, so Sagittarius, this is interesting. So the issue we've already discussed, this is fire energy, the Ace of Wands. Clearly what I'm seeing there is that there is an opportunity for you to grasp, and the time to do this would be now. Okay. But the challenge is coming up as the Seven of Pentacles, okay? So this person is sort of limited by how long it takes for a crop to grow. So the Seven of Pentacles, we're looking at, you know, the whole idea is you've already done a lot of work, okay? You've already done what's necessary. Your challenge now is to wait, to have the patience to wait. And Sagittarius, you do have patience. You know, and this is Saturn in Taurus. Taurus might be significant to you. You know that Saturn you know, is the planet of restrictions. I don't know what else I can say about this except that there's a big payoff coming. That's how I feel. Let's see what's crowning your reading. Okay, so we got to look out here. We've got a stage card. Okay, so we have the Six of Pentacles. We know that it is a stage card because we can see a gray flat surface there. So what that means is that the main character in the card is not really and in this card he's trying to look charitable, but he's not really being charitable. In this card, you'll notice that one of the beggars is looking a little more needy than the other. It's the guy in blue. He has no hat, and his coat is sort of tattered and torn. For some reason, the man who is trying to look generous is giving only to the other person. You see that there is one pentacle over the head of the man who is dressed in red, and his scales are just slightly imbalanced. It means that he's investing. So the reason why he has chosen to give to this sort of more reliable looking beggar is because his money is tied up in it. So it's sort of a selfish thing. It's not real giving. It's not a balanced card. It's Moon in Taurus. The Moon does well in Taurus, actually, so it's a good card for love, but the relationship may be a bit unbalanced. Sagittarius, I'm just noticing as well, you know, so in love it's not that bad of a card, the Six of Pentacles. It just may mean that your lover may have a little bit of an upper hand. Okay. However, it is a very good combination in terms of luck when the Wheel of Fortune is on the table, and it is in your case. Okay. So let's see what's grounding the reading. Nice. Mercury in your sign. Mercury in Sagittarius. This is definitely your reading, Sagittarius. So you have some incoming communication. This communication is going to be imminent. In other words, it's coming very soon. It's likely going to be love-related. If it isn't, it is victory-related. It is very, very good news. The timing associated with this card is now. Okay, so what's in your recent past? Oh, well, Sagittarius, there may have been a Cancer in your recent past, or you may have had some sort of a victory, or you may have gotten something off the ground in doing so. You may have found it necessary to sort of rein in your emotions to get total mental mastery over the whole situation. And you did this with grace and style. You didn't even need to have reins on these sphinxes. Or in the witch's tarot at the dark and the white horse. So that's great. Whatever you've been doing is fantastic. This reading is looking amazing, and so is the near future. So we have the integrals here. Okay. So this is the Sun in Virgo, I think. I'm thinking that an earth sign, either a Taurus or a Virgo, is important to you. And I'm thinking that your love interest is very focused on you and willing to put in a lot of work for you. And they've had this realization. And you know what's happening right now? There's some kind of song that reminds this person of you, and it's going over and over in their head. That's what I'm seeing here. A little break in the tape, and we're going to drive right on through the last part of your reading, Sagittarius. Okay, Saggy. So we're going to look at the energy that you are bringing into this situation. So you're feeling a little bit sad or a little bit heartbroken about something. Possibly, this sometimes can be a little bit of betrayal, but mostly when I look at this card, I want you to look at the rain And those are tears. Those are somebody's tears. So this is Saturn in Libra. But you know what? It's just your energy. This is very easy to get out. What I'm seeing in this reading is just phenomenal. I think you can release that energy. Okay, Sag? Now let's look at what the outside influences are. Oh, wow. Sagittarius, this is beautiful. So we now have two of your major arcana cards on the table. We had the Wheel of Fortune, which was on the bottom of the deck, and look at you. Here's Temperance, the ultimate alchemist. This is the angel of time. there's a symbol, if you've ever wondered what the symbol is on her chest, the triangle within the square there. I believe that it is one of the Hebrew meanings for God. So this is quite an angel. And her wings are red, meaning that she is very passionate about what she is doing here. And I'm seeing this all over your reading. You're working so hard. You've grasped that opportunity with the Ace of Wands. I believe that what she is pouring back and forth may be the past and the future, okay? She is the angel of time. She is also the ultimate alchemist. So you are really focused on what you're doing, and you are going to be very, very successful. If you're involved with someone who is very, very different from you, it is going to work extremely well. Okay, now let's look at your hopes and fears. Oh, this is interesting. So you've got a lot of options. So here we have the Seven of Cups. Now, this is a fascinating card. This is Venus in Scorpio. So the main message, I would say, of this card is to be very careful about the choices that you make, and don't be distracted by glitter. Just as a very, very, small example, do you see the castle? That's sort of the blue castle that's in one of the cups there. It looks very inviting, doesn't it? Well, it later becomes the tower. Little break in the tape, Saggy. Yeah, so there's absolutely nothing bad about the Seven of Cups. In fact, if you choose wisely, for example, you might get this. Do you see that big head with the bushy hairdo there? Apparently, that is supposed to be the Empress. And the cup in the very middle that looks like a lampshade. Underneath is the High Priestess along with the moon. And the snake is actually the Magician. So it's interesting because all the things that look really good turn out to be sort of disastrous. And the things that look sort of boring turn out to be wonderful. It makes me think of the quote by J.R.R. Tolkien. Actually, I'm not even sure if it was him that wrote it, but all that glitters is not gold. you may have a concern right now that the person that you're involved with is just glitter. So maybe just look closer, or you may not want to be distracted by allure or illusion right now. Sagittarius, your mutable fire. You have mental mastery over all the forces. I don't think that you're going to be distracted by glitter. Well, I'm excited to look at the outcome, Saggy. Ooh, the Hermit. Well, if you are interested in an earth sign, there he is, there's Virgo. This person is the ultimate spiritual master. He's been through everything in the deck. He is guided there by there's a six-pointed star in his lantern that is supposed to represent Solomon's seal of knowledge. Other people say it's simply the universe. He has a lot of knowledge to give. I think we need to clarify, Sagittarius, because I'm not entirely sure what this means. If it's a love reading and you're interested in a Virgo, well, there you go. There's your answer right there. If not, shall we clarify? Okay. Generally, I'm looking for a jumper in this situation. So can we clarify the hermit as the outcome for mutable fire, please? Sorry, Sag. A little break in the tape. Sorry. Okay, so we're still trying to clarify the hermit as the outcome for Sagittarius, please. Can we have... Okay, okay, we got two. Sagittarius. you're losing some sleep about a love offer, but it is coming in, okay? It may be a Pisces, but it is coming in. This is a love message. An offer, okay? It may be from a young, dark-haired man. also, I don't mean to scare anyone, but if you have been trying to get pregnant, you may be pregnant. Sometimes the fish in that little cup is interpreted that way. So you can stop losing sleep over all this. This looks like an absolutely beautiful outcome. And look at that at the bottom of the deck. I just picked up the deck that we were using to clarify. There you are. There's the Page of Wands. And you had the Ace of Wands and the Eight of Wands. You've got a wonderful, passionate endeavor ongoing and in your very near future. So congratulations, Sagittarius. It was really fun checking in with you. I'll be back.